It's a crystal.
Yeah, we have to smash it.
Looks like he's got other ideas.
Poor King Tom.
We'll have to give him a right royal battering.
Right there.
Okay, here goes. Sanctify!
The mana was fed by the energy that flowed from the black crystals. They formed the cornerstones of the forbidden spell.
I'm sure they did, but now they have been destroyed.
Surely a mere human could not have carried out such a deed.
Could he really be the one?
Your Radiance, what do you intend to do about this?
Fear not. The manor is but a foretaste of what is yet to come. This trifling victory only delays the inevitable.
Indeed. The more mankind struggles, the more surely its fate is sealed.
Yes, they cling to a frail, bleating hope. But it is soon to be torn from them.
to see mere mortals raise arms against your radiance.
An amusing spectacle. We look forward to it. Now, Gallus, are we to understand that you have had contact with the boy?
I have. I wished to gauge his power.
Gauge his power? And you expect us to believe this? Can it be? First Shaddaa, and now you.
You doubt the word of a fellow counselor?
What nonsense!
Enough!
Your radiance.
Enough, I say.
Yes, radiance.
May I, your radiance?
King, your father, he slipped away most peacefully.
But he's there. Why are you crying?
No, I'm not crying.
Your Highness, it is time for you to take your father's place.
You mean I'll be Queen Pea?
Yes, that is what is expected. Your radiance.
Really? I wonder if I'll be a good queen.
And so, the preparations for the succession are all in place.
All matters of state have been entrusted to the Council of Twelve.
That's right. You don't have to worry your pretty little head about a thing.
Look at her. Princess P hasn't the faintest idea what's going on.
She is no longer a mere princess.
Ah, you are quite right. Please accept my humblest apologies, Queen P.
You look simply radiant, Princess P.
But we had better start calling you by your true name, Queen Cassiopeia.
But Father called me P.
You're a big girl now, and after today's ceremony, you'll be known by your big grown-up name.
But I...
Your subjects are all toasting your health, Queen Cassiopeia.
They're sure that you'll take after the Wizard King and lead our kingdom to a glorious future.
But I'm P. I don't want to be a queen.
Thank you. Thank you.
No choice but to fight!
Thank you.
Choice but to fight!
Ugh. to battle then.
That big beast looks cowing familiar.
Oh no! The cow leafer too?
Thank you.
Apis, at least I have you to talk to. What the council are doing? Can it be right? Earlier on, I overheard the captain of the guards. He said the kingdom was in a parlous state. He spoke of people too poor to buy bread and of the starving dying in the streets. Yet, the council assure me all is well. Just who is telling the truth? Tell me, Apis.
This is most troubling. The Queen persists in her wish to involve herself in the affairs of state.
Should this continue, she may realize that it is we who now rule the kingdom and alert the populace.
Surely it would do little harm to allow her to sit on the council, provided that we keep the more sensitive matters from Her Majesty's hearing.
Yes, and ensure that she is made publicly responsible for all of the council's decisions.
Ha! A most splendid idea. We shall keep our kingdom while she takes all the blame.
Father, I know you will be proud of me.
Today,
the council gave me their approval.
I am to be involved in the affairs of state.
Now I can work for the best interests of my subjects. I have taken a long, hard look at myself, and I have decided to put my subjects first and do all I can to rid the world of war and famine. Father, I have learned of the existence of an ancient spell with the power to end all suffering. I shall do you proud. I vow that I will master that spell and save my subjects and kingdom from despair. Soon, Father. Soon I shall bring the light of hope into the lives of my people.
Thank you. Thank you.